ஹலோ ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ எம் டாக்டர் கே கண்ணன், ப்ரொஃபஸர் மெக்கானிக்கல் இன்ஜினியரிங், அஞ்சலி அம்மாள் மகாலிங்கம் இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ், கோவில்வண்ணி. ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி டு மீட் யூ அகெய்ன் த்ரூ தி லெக்சர் நம்பர் 6 ஆன் மாடியூல் 1 இன் தி சப்ஜெக்ட் ஆப்ரேஷன் ரிசர்ச். டுடே தி டாபிக் ஃபார் டிஸ்கஷன் இஸ் பிக் எம் மெத்தட். வில் ரீகேப் ஃப்ரம் தி ப்ரீவியஸ் லெக்சர். இன் தி ப்ரீவியஸ் லெக்சர் வி டிஸ்கஸ் தி சிம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் மெத்தட் and we solved a few problems using the simplex method. In the simplex method, the requirement is all the constraint should be with less than or equal to symbol, and all the constraint with non-negative right hand side. So these two are required. So necessarily, if you have less than or equal to symbol, so automatically the right hand side will be non-negative. When this condition is satisfied, we can solve the problem by the simplex method. But in practice, there are constraints other than less than or equal to symbol. So in those cases, we have to solve the problem by Big M method or two-phase method. So the LPP with less than or equal to constraint with the non-negative right-hand side can be solved by the simplex method. But when the constraint equations with the greater than or equal to or equal to symbol will violate the non-negative right-hand side condition, cannot be solved by the simplex method. So in those cases, we have to use the problems, solve the linear programming problem either by Big M method or penalty method. So the Big M method is also called as penalty method or two-phase method. So in this lecture, we will discuss about the Big M method. And in the next lecture, we talk about the two-phase method. So the Big M method, the procedure, algorithm, calculation, everything is similar to the simplex method. But there are some little modification with respect to the constraints. We understand the Big M technique using a problem. Maximize z equal to 2x1 plus 3x2 minus 5x3. Subject to a constraint of x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 7 and 2x1 minus 5x2 plus x3 greater than or equal to 10, x1, x2, x3 are greater than or equal to 0. Now look at the constraint. First constraint has got the equal symbol and the second constraint has got the greater than or equal to symbol. So now in our regular procedure, we have to convert the constraint inequalities into equalities. So in the second constraint, I have to subtract the surplus variable. So subtracting the surplus variable, we have to convert the LPP into standard form. The standard form of LPP, look at the constraint. First constraint as it is, x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 7. Second constraint, 2x1 minus 5x2 plus x3 minus s1. So we added, subtracted minus s1 equal to 10. And the x1, x2, x3 and s1 are greater than or equal to 0. And there is only one surplus variable in the second constraint, so that is included in the objective function. Z equal to 2x1 plus 3x2 minus 5x3 plus 0, s1. Now, in the problem, there are four variables, x1, x2, x3 and s1. And there are two constraints, four variable and two constraint equations. So, number of variables in the problem equal to 4. Number of constraint in the problem equal to m equal to 2. So number of non-basic variables, it is n minus m equal to 2. So we have to identify among the four variables, we have to fix two variables are non-basic variables, that is decision variables. So the non-basic variables what we identify is x1 and x2, and the basic variables are x3 and s1. Now to find the basic solution, our methodology is fix the non-basic variable to 0. So put x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0 in the constraint equation. We will get x3 equal to 7 and s1 equal to minus 1, z equal to minus 35. This is the starting solution. But this is not correct. Why it is not correct? S1 takes the negative value. So it violates the condition. It violates the non-negative condition of the variables. So we cannot proceed further. So we have to make it. You have to make the condition to be satisfied. So to satisfy the condition, what is condition? The variables, all the variables are non-negative. To satisfy the condition, we are introducing the artificial variables in the constraint equations. So introduce artificial variable to the constraint equation. So first constraint x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus r1 equal to 7 and 2x1 minus 5x2 plus x3 minus s1 plus r2 equal to 10. So r1, r2, they are called as artificial variables. And now look at the problem. There are 6 variables. Number of variables n equal to 6. Number of constraint equation m equal to 2. And number of non-basic variables n minus m equal to 4. Now the non-basic variables are x1, x2, x3 and s1. And the basic variables are r1 and r2. Then we have to find the basic solution as usual. Set the non-basic variable to 0. X1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, x3 equal to 0, s1 equal to 0, which leads to r1 equal to 7, r2 equal to 10. Now everything, all the variables are non-negative. The condition is satisfied. Now the objective equation. Z equal to 2x1 plus 3x2 minus 5x3 plus 0 s1 plus r value. M r1 plus m r2. M is the coefficient for the artificial variable. The coefficient m, we have to assign the value, right? What the value? The value m, value of m should be most negative value for maximization type of problem and the most positive value for the minimization type of problem. So here it is maximization type of problem. I take most negative value, I assign m equal to minus 100. So 2x1 plus 3x2 minus 5x3 plus 0 s1 minus 100 r1 minus 100 r2. Now the r1 r2 value, we have to substitute r1 r2 value from the constraint equation. So from the constraint equation, I take r1 equal to 7 minus x1 minus x2 minus x3, r2 equal to 10 minus 2x1 plus 5x2 minus x3 minus s1. So this is from the first constraint, this is from the second constraint. And substitute r1, r2 in the objective function, simplify, I will get z minus 302 x1 plus 397 x2 minus 195 x3 plus 100 s1 equal to minus 1700. So this is the objective function and everything is given in the table number, table. So this is the starting solution. So z, x1, x2, x3, s1, non-basic variables, r1, r2 basic variables, solution column, z row, r1 row, r2 row. Z row, all the values from the objective function, 1, minus 302, 397, minus 195, 100, 0, 0, minus 1700. R1 value, r2 value from the constraint equation. So here we have the constraint equation. So this is r1 equation, this is r2 equation. Substitute the value here. R1, R1 equation 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 7 and 0, 2, minus 5, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 10. Now, among the decision variables, non-basic variables, we have to identify the most negative value for maximization type of problem. That is entering. The entering variable is most negative. So, 302 is the most negative. So, x1 is entering. So once x1 is entering, then you have to calculate the intercept. Intercept is the solution column value divided by the entering column value. So 7 divided by 1, 7, 10 divided by 2, 5. So among the two intercept, the most, the minimum value is the leaving variable. So the leaving variable is r. So x1 is the entering variable, r2 is the leaving variable, and the pivot number is 2. Now entering column is x1. Most negative coefficient is z row, leaving row is r2, least intercept and the pivot number is 2. Now we have to calculate the new pivot row, new z row, new r1 row using the formula. New pivot row equal to old pivot row r2 divided by the pivot number. New z row equal to current z row minus its entering column coefficient in the into new pivot row. New R1 row equal to current R1 row minus its entering column coefficient into new pivot row. So using the equations, you calculate the new table and the new solution is this. This is the new solution. So once again, look at the basic variable, decision variables. X1, 0, X2, minus 358, X3, minus 44, S1, minus 51. So it is a maximization type of problem. This is the most negative value. Now this is entering, x2 is entering. When x2 is entering, so this is denominator is negative, so you cannot consider this for intercept. So 2 divided by 3.5, r1 is leaving. So r1 is leaving variable, x2 is the entering variable, and 3.5 is the pivot number. So the solution is not optimum, go to the third iteration. For third iteration, x2 is the entering variable, r1 is the leaving variable, and 3.5 is the pivot number. So entering column is x2, leaving row is r1, and the pivot number is 3.5. Now, once again, new pivot row, x2 equal to current pivot row divided by the pivot number. New z row, current z row minus its entering column coefficient into new pivot row. And new x1 row equal to current x1 row minus of minus 2.5, that is entering column coefficient, new pivot row. So using the equation, calculating the result. The result is this. This is the result. Now look at the table. Look at the z row values of the non-basic variable, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, x3 equal to 7.4, s1 equal to 0.14. So all the four values are positive, there is no negative value, and this solution is optimal. Now what is the solution? The solution is x1 equal to 6.43, x2 equal to 0.57, and z equal to 14.57. That is the solution for the problem. So there are two artificial variables. With the two iterations, we calculate the optimum solution. So for maximization type of problem. So this is the Big M method for maximization type of problem. Then I take another problem. Minimize z equal to 4x1 plus 6x2 subject to 4x1 plus 5x2 greater than or equal to 10, 4x1 plus 8x2 greater than or equal to 5, and minus 2x1 plus 3x2 equal to 3. So here, the first constraint and the second constraint, we have to subtract the surplus variable, making it to standard form. So the standard form of the equation, 4x1 plus 5x2 minus s1 equal to 10, 4x1 plus 8x2 minus s2 equal to 5, minus 2x1 plus 3x2 equal to 3. Now, x1, x2, s1, s2 are greater than or equal to 0. We got two surplus variables. So, introduce the surplus variable in the objective function, minimize z equal to 4x1 plus 6x2 plus 0 s1 plus 0 s2. Now, here, we have four variables, x1, x2, s1, s2, s1, s2, and three constraint equation. So number of variable equal to 4, number of constraint equal to 3, and number of non-basic variable equal to n minus m equal to 1. So we fix x1 is the non-basic variable or the decision variable, and the basic variables are x2, s1, s2. Now you fix x1 equal to 0, and I will get x2 equal to 1, s1 equal to minus 10, s2 equal to minus 5, and z equal to 4. So here, s1, s2 takes the negative value, which violates the non-negative condition of the variable. So we introduce the artificial variable in all the three constraints. So in the first constraint, second constraint, third constraint, we introduce the artificial variable, r1, r2, r3. So 4x1 plus 5x2 minus s1 plus r1 equal to 10, 4x1 plus 8x2 minus s2 plus r2 equal to 5, minus 2x1 plus 3x2 plus r3 equal to 3. Now the number of variables are 7, number of constraints are 3, number of non-basic variables are 4. So the additional variables are x1, x2, s1, s2, and basic variables are r1 and r2. So fixing the non-basic variable to 0, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, s1 equal to 0, s2 equal to 0, which leads to r1 equal to 10, r2 equal to 5, and r3 equal to 3. Now it satisfies the condition. Non-negative values of all the variables. Introducing the r1, r2, r3 in the objective equation, 4x1 plus 6x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus mr1 plus mr2 plus mr3. Substitute large positive value for the m. So here it is minimization type of problem. M will take the positive value, most positive value. We fix m equal to 100. So substituting 4x1 plus 6x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 100 r1 plus 100 R2 plus 100 R3. Now R1, R2, R3 from the constant equation. So from the constant equation, we have to find out R1, R2, R3, and we have to substitute here. So R1, R2, R3 from the constant equation, substituting and simplifying, I will get Z equal to 596 X1 plus 1594 X2 plus 100 S2 minus 100 S2 minus, excuse me, 1 minute, there is a mistake. Here it is S1. S1 minus. So minus 100 S1 minus 100 S2 equal to 1800. So the result, basic result, is given in the table. So Z, X1, X2, S1, S2, R1, R2, R3, solution column, Z row, R1, R2, R3 row. In the minimization type of problem, you check the non-basic variable. X1, X2, S1, S2 are the non-basic variables. And here, X2 takes the most positive value, and this is entering. The entering variable is X2. Once you have the entering variable, then we have to calculate the intercept. So 10 divided by 5, 5 divided by 8, and 3 divided by 3. The minimum value is 5 by 8, and R2 is the leaving variable. So X2 is the entering variable, R2 is the leaving variable. Now the solution, entering variable is X2, leaving variable is R2, and the pivot number is 8. So we have 4 rows, new pivot row. You take current pivot row, divide by pivot number, new Z row, current Z row, its entering column coefficient into new pivot row, new R1 row equal to current R1 row minus of 5, that is its entering column coefficient, new pivot row, and R3 row, new R3 row equal to current R3 row minus 3, entering column coefficient. So this is what the entering column coefficient, 5, 8, 3. Then calculating, using these equations, calculating the new result. The new result is given here. So you look at the table once again. X1, X2, S1, S2, R1, R2, R3, all these iterations. Using the equations, we calculated. Once again, look at the table. So the among the non-basic variable, most positive, because it is minimization type of problem. So 99.25, S2 takes the value of 99.25, that is what the entering variable. Entering variable we identified, and we have to calculate the intercept. So this is negative denominator, you should not consider this. So 6.88 divided by 0.62, 1.12 divided by 0.38, the least value is 1.12 divided by 0.38, so this is what leaving. So entering is S2, leaving is R3, pivot number is 0.38. Now, entering variable S2, leaving variable R3, pivot number 0.38, and all the four equations. New pivot row, S2 equal to current pivot row divided by the pivot number. New Z row equal to current Z row minus 99.25 into new pivot row. New R1 row equal to current R1 row minus 0.62 into new pivot row. And new X2 row equal to current X2 row minus of minus 0.12 into new pivot row. So these values 99.25, 0.62, minus 0.12, they are the entering column coefficients. So considering using the four equations, calculating the result, this is the result. So Z, X1, X2, S1, S2, R1, R2, R3. So look at the table. Once again, check the non-basic variable, X1, X2, S1, S2. So here again, X1 is entering now because it is the most positive value. So X1 is entering, R1 is leaving because these two are not considered because of negative denominator. So R1 is leaving, X1 is entering, and 7.33 is the pivot number. So entering column is X1, leaving row is R1, and pivot number is 7.33. And everything calculated. So new pivot row X1 equal to current pivot row R1 divided by pivot number. New Z row equal to current Z row minus of 725.33 new pivot row. New X2 row equal to current X2 row minus of minus 0.67 new pivot row. New S2 row equal to current S2 row minus of minus 0.9.33 into new pivot row. So using the four equations, calculating the new result. So this is the new result. So using the four equations, we have calculated from the previous table. Now look at the non-basic variable, x1 0, x2 0, s1 minus 1.09, s2 equal to 0. So there is no positive value for the minimization type of problem, and this is what the optimum. Now what is the result? X1 equal to 0.68, x2 equal to 1.45, and z minimum equal to 11.45. So this is the answer. X1 equal to 0.68, x2 equal to 1.45, and z equal to 11.45. That is the answer for the minimization type of problem. So service to the others is the rent you pay for your room here on the earth. That is given by Muhammad Ali, the leading famous boxer from USA. Thank you very much. We'll meet again.